होप यू ऑल आर फाइन हेल्दी एंड यू ऑल आर कंटिन्यू विद योर स्टडीज. यस एंड टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद अ न्यू चैप्टर इन अ ग्रामर बुक. होप यू ऑल हैव परचेज्ड योर बुक्स. यस ओके ओके लेट अस स्टार्ट विद अ न्यू चैप्टर फ्रॉम योर ग्रामर बुक चैप्टर 2 सब्जेक्ट्स एंड प्रेडिकेट्स. यस Now see what is subject and predicates. We will be reading about subject and predicate students. A sentence is made of up of two parts, the subject and the predicates. As you all have earlier, we have read about sentences. What is sentences? Sentences is made up of similar words. From way by which we can convey a message, we can talk to each other with your friends, with your parents. That thing is known as sentences. Whatever we the sentences which we are using in our day-to-day life. Now we will be reading about subjects and predicates. Now see, the subject of a complete sentence is who or what the sentences is about. Subjects are generally noun, pronoun, determiners or adjectives. Now see some examples are given. See the example number 1. Mr. Sharma teaches in a school. The dog is a faithful animal. She plays badminton every day. Now see. In the above sentences, the colored words are the subjects. A subjects may be the name of a person or animal or a pronoun. A subject indicates to the person or things that does the action. Like subject is a thing in which we know about a person or like a person name or animal. So these are all come in the subjects. Now see, a sentence must have a subject and a verb. Now we will be hope you all have understood the subject. The subject is a name of a person or animals or a pronoun. Now see, what are predicates? The predicates is the part of a sentences which says something about the subject. This is the remaining part of the sentences after the subject. Generally, it starts with the verb. It is made up of one or more than one word. Okay, now see the example students. Nisha is reading a novel. Dev works in a school. Seema goes to school daily. Now see, as you all know that what is Nisha? Nisha is a subject. And what is reading a novel? Reading a novel will be your predicate. That it's telling about the action of Nisha. What Nisha is doing. Nisha is reading a novel. It is telling about the action of a Nisha. Now see the next one. Dev works in a school. Dev is a name of a person. And so Dev will be the subject. And works in a school will be the action of Dev, what the Dev is doing, like works in a school. Now see the third one. Seema goes to school daily. Seema is again a name of a person. Goes to school daily will be your predicates. Hope till here you all have understood. Yes, students. Now see, in the above sentence, the colored words, that colored words mean here the words given in the blue are the predicates, as these words say something about the subject. That I told you, these words are telling about the subject. Like these are telling about, like the in your first example, Nisha is reading a novel. Predicates is telling about the Nisha, and Nisha will be your subject. Now see, position of the subject in a sentence. Now we will read about the subject's position. A subject can be placed anywhere in a sentence. It can be placed in the beginning, in the middle or at the end of the sentence. Sometimes it is silent or hidden. Beta, here we can add subject anywhere in the sentence. Like when we write a complete sentence, though it is not necessary that we should start with the subject or ends with the subject. We can use subjects anywhere. Like sometimes we write some sentence like your teacher has given to make sentences. Like you have given one word like friends. Friendship is your word that is given by your teacher, and you have to do the make sentences of that. Then what you will write? My friend is Rahul. So Rahul is your friend, and Rahul is also a name of a person. Then it will be your subject. But Rahul word is coming at the last. So we can write and we can add subject anywhere in the sentence. A subject can take place anywhere. Hope you all have understood, students. Yes, let us read the next page. Now see, for example, as I told you, Kanika is reading a story. Subject is in the beginning. See, Kanika is in the beginning. Beginning means starting. Did he come to the party? Now he. Beta, whenever you all know what is hidden meaning. Hidden word is the like he, you, I. Like sometimes what we do, we never take the person's name. So what we use? He. Like your ma'am has asked, where is Rahul gone? Then what you will say? He has gone to toilet, he has gone to washroom. You will say like this, so this is hidden word. See here, in second example, did he come to the party? He means he is also using for a person. Now see the third one. Ding dong, when the bell. The bell is a subject. It's ending with the bell. That means subject is coming at the end. Mind your own business. Now subject is silent or hidden. Like own word. Own is also used for a person. That a person should do its own work. Like if own is donated for person. Hope you all have understood each and everything, students. If you have any problem again, please let me know. We will discuss it again. Okay, let us come with the new exercise. Yes, take out your pencils and do the exercises. Now see the first one. Take the correct option. The girl ate the pizza. It will be a predicate. Next week my grandmother is coming from Australia. Subject. Because grandmother is a person. My favorite month is March. Then it will be predicate. Blue is my favorite color. It will be predicate. My friend and I went shopping. That means subject. Friend is a subject because it's a person. Now see the next exercise. B1. Find out the subjects and predicates from the following. First one. Don't tease the animal. Animal will be your subjects, and don't tease will be your predicates. The second one, students, you should not go there. And subject will be you should, because devoted for human being. Not go there will be a predicate. Now third one, we went to visit the Taj Mahal. Taj Mahal is also a subject, and went to visit will be your predicates. Lucknow is the capital of Uttar Pradesh. And Lucknow will be subject and predicates will be capital. The baby is crying. Students, see the sixth one. Cow gives us milk. Cow will be your subject and predicates will be the milk. Now the C and D will be doing as your homework. Do complete your work in your books itself with the help of your pencils. Hope you all have understood the chapter. Take care. Have a good day. Thank you for the day, students.